Hello there, my name is Emin, EMG Soft, and in this video I wanted to start a new series of videos dedicated to setting up robots in Bitrix 24. So that series of videos will include all type of robots which you able to use in leads and deals. These robots in leads and deals quite the same, so that robots not exist in contact the company, only in leads and deals. And I will talk in my next videos about custom communication robots, triggers and robots, employee alerts, it will be this video today, employee monitoring, paperwork, payment, delivery, repeat sales, ads, manage, workflow item, customer information, task management, data storage, workflow information, and other. So I got the whole list here. And each video will be dedicated for each of this item. Because in one video, if I will put all information, it will be too long video. I decided to split for each group of robots. This video, I will start with employee alerts because it's most commonly used robots in Bitrix 24. And second, it's quite easy them to set up. So let's start with employee alerts. When you go to leads or deals, doesn't matter, in our example, you can go inside of the leads, you can go to Kanban view, list view, activities and calendar. So Kanban view, when you go to stages, list it's just all leads just as a list, activities is just a lead sorted by deadlines, and calendar view. Okay, doesn't matter for us particular video. Inside of the leads, we go to automation rules. In automation rules, you got the same stages as in Kanban view, and for each Kanban stage, you can set up a robot. So what we should do now? We click create and go to employee alerts group. Group means automation rules grouped by the respective function. So employee alerts function. Add notification. Send a notification to employee from selector sender. What does that mean? So we can create that robot. Click add. Now we're setting up that robot. Right. So why we need that robot and what that robot actually doing? For example, you need to notify a responsible person of the lead that you got lead. Responsible person lead could be set up by, for example, CRM forms, or for example, somebody left their contact details in CRM form and you assign responsible person for that form. About forms I will talk on another videos. Or for example, you done integration via Facebook or Instagram or something else, and you set up there who is responsible person. So anyway, somehow lead created and you need to send a notification to the responsible person that he got a new lead to not let him miss that lead. Okay. So we can, for example, run that robot immediately. Robot run immediately means that once lead created, that particular robot send notification immediately. Or you can run that after 10 minutes, or after 10 hours, or after 10 days. We will play with that notification with different situation. The first situation, run that notification immediately. So it's quite understandable what it's about. And we will not put any condition for now, just make it more simple. And for example, we'll set notification to the employee like a new lead created, and inside of that text we can put name of a lead. To put the name of that lead, we can click here three dots, click lead, and find lead name. Okay, why lead name? Because by different robots or in CRM forms, you can put a lead name which is responsible, for example, contact name, phone number, and date, just as an example. A new lead name created. Please take an action immediately. Who is the sender? Sender could be as a boss, okay? Or it could be head of department. You can select by roles, or you can select by user. So recipient, responsible person of the lead. Save. Okay, let's test that robot. Now, I will create a lead, and once I create a lead, I should get notification that lead created. Responsible person. hey, I got notification that lead created. So if I'm going to get notification, a new lead test 111 created, please take an action. So we can put here any other text here. Okay, let's do slight modification of that robot. Edit. For example, we can add here created on, means like time lead created. And for example, we will put here like you should to respond to that during 15 minutes. We will put here name of responsible person. I mean, you should call back to that client during next 15 minutes. Okay. Let's take a test. I create a lead. So I got notification, new lead created, created 7th of July, 8:30, next minutes. So we got that notification. And now we can send another notification to supervisor and to responsible person that he didn't respond to that client during 15 minutes. Okay. Now we can add another notification with some logic. We're going to automation rule and we create another robot, employer, let's add notification. And here, what we can do is that, for example, you give to your employee only 15 minutes to reply to that lead, okay? And for example, by your business logic, your manager should take care of that lead during 15 minutes. And once he take care of that lead, he need to move from you to process it. Means that if you move to that stage, means that he working with client, okay? So how we can set up that? Run after previous automation rule means that that automation rule should run only after that automation rule, so first notification, right? Also, so that notification run immediately, so that works. And then we put run after 15 minutes after current time, means set up in server over Bittrex. And so respect working hours, specific Bittrex settings, so when client, so working time, a responsible person working time. Okay, so that's why we can use that as well. Okay, 15 minutes. So run after 15 minutes after once that notification worked. So we go into lead, find to status equal to and new, select what we done. If after 15 minutes a lead, because we run robots for particular leads in the same status, which is new, we done that check. So send a second notification. I mean, where's responsible person? Responsible person name, which is Amin. You didn't. Run free. You didn't contact it to client, and we put here client name or lead name. So we can put lead name. And sender will be a supervisor or head of department. So we can set up exact person. Save. Okay. So we send that notification. Also, we can send the same notification to the boss. Employee, add notification. Run after the previous, so after that, once that run, we run in that robot. That means that we don't need that. So we can use current time, because anyway, that robot will run after this robot, so we need to use only after previous automation rule. Okay, and we do a double check. Lead status equal to new, select, and so recipient will be supervisor, or you can select exact person, for example will be Mike Smith, and sender will be admin of the portal, for example lead and comment. So means regular comment inside to the lead. For example, okay, we will not put any condition here. We will just put some comments. For example, lead move from new stage to processes stage. For example, necessary data collected. You will need that to the history of that lead. So means that they didn't move directly to the deals, just they run certain stages inside to the lead. For example, lead name past stage processed, and we check in the lead once, because that robot we system automatically added the command name past stage processes. So here you can add any other commands. So go next to automation rule. Let's create employee alerts, add a post. For example, you moved a lead from lead stage to deal stage. So you successfully closed lead as a deal. Make a post of the feed means that everybody should know that that lead now a deal, and who want to take it, or just everybody want to know that, you know, you got a new deal. And what we can say, put here, congratulate everyone, we have a new deal. And we can put here deal name, and deal name in our case will be the same as lead name. And for example, everybody who so sender will be admin, and responsible person will be not responsible person, but just all people in your departments. For example, sales department, okay, all employees, okay, all employees in the in sales department will be have that in the feed. So we can add attachments, and so we can some put some information, save. And I need to put that robot here, because once we completed a lead as a good lead that convert to the deal, and you got a post. Okay, so I need to be sure that I'm in department, so I will put that myself here. Okay, save. Let's test. So good lead, okay, just deal. Okay, I forget to do one thing here in that robot. I used current time, and I switch off that checkboxes. Just run that immediately. So save. Now I run as a successful deal. Save and go to the feed. So I got that done. What else? We can create another robot. Employee alerts, add a post, add command, send an email. So, for example, your employees not use Bitrix as a system which is, working constant base. So we need to get notification by email that, for example, lead created. For that, you can each time send an email to your employee that he got in lead. So you created that robot, click here, current time, okay. Use that, or exact time, for example. If, for example, he got a new lead, you can send current date, use current time, select, and probably it will be some condition. For example, he could be a particular responsible person, but in that case, we'll not use any condition. From admin to responsible person, but where you taking responsible person email? So for responsible person email, you taking from his profile. So I will go here, and if you go to responsible person profile, you put contact email here. So to that email, responsible person will get that notification. Okay, from the responsible person, and for example, new lead created, and we'll put here name of that lead. Dear responsible person name, please take an action immediately. So you can attach files, you can run after previous, or in that case it will be immediately. Save, and let's do the test. So I'm creating a lead, and then I will check off my email. Okay, so that created. Now I will go to my email. In my mail, I see that new created, lead name, admin, responsible name, and the text. So, good to use. What else? Go to automation rules. The same story, we got send SMS to employee, right? So add and so on. But to send SMS, so before that, you need to install our application TweeSMS. To install our application, you need to go to the market, type here 3SMS. Go to ESMS and install it. So you need to install it. Okay, so you need to go through the installation process here. Yeah, so you need to use seed, account seed and so on. So if you not understand how to do that, you can watch that video. If you need help, just click this button and we will do the help of you how we can do that settings. But before that, you need to create a Twilio account. So type Twilio, go to Twilio and create an account, start for free. Okay, that application used Twilio as a provider. So you can run, for example, run immediately, and the same story as an email, responsible name, new lead name, created, take an action, and the employee will be responsible, and the same story. So SMS will be sent to that phone number. And also in that particular robot, you need to select TSMS. TSMS, send SMS via Twilio. Done. Save. That's it. So it will happen the same way. So where was our robot? Yeah, here. Yeah. And once I create a new lead. Okay, I got notification. I got email. And I also got an SMS. So we discussed all these five robots. Hope that will be helpful for you. And in the next videos, I will discuss other groups. So you can combine this, just click on different conditions on these robots and you will understand better how it is working. Okay, so if you got the questions, put your questions in the comments of that video. And thank you and bye-bye.